Yeah, I know. I know. Don't even say it. Don't even say it. Yes, I bowled for Titus. Do not ask me how much I spent, because it was lots, but I'd say it was worth it. I know I've made my opinion on Titus as a character very clear on this channel multiple times. I'm not going to revisit any of that, though, because facts are facts. This dude is so insanely strong. He is so good in this game. And I've been doing a little bit of tier 10 research, and I don't want to go into that mess without him. I know it's possible to do it without him, but I don't care. I just want to go in guns blazing on that one. For me, the most important thing is beating the content. And more important than that, the most important thing to me is beating the content with relative ease. Whatever. So I pulled for Titus. My time is way more important than my gems. That's how I view this. So that's why I pulled for Titus. And I'm not gonna lie, he's really fun to play. I do like his animations with him flipping around and shit. He's super fun to watch, fun to play. I like him in this game. I gotta admit. Not in 10 so much, but on default, I am a Titus fan. I cannot believe I just said that out loud. But hey, facts are facts. Anyways, this fight. This fight is easy. With this setup, anyway. I don't know what it's like if you do something less oppressive. But I guess we'll find out for Dare to Defy. Because I am not bringing Titus to this. For the Dare to Defy version. I keep forgetting the name of it. Even there, then I like jumbled over my words trying to say it. Dare to Defy. Which I think I know what I'm going to do with that. I think, you know what? No, never mind. Never mind. I'm not going to commit to anything. We'll see. Because I'm not sure how I'm going to do videos for that yet. I did the first one. I just powered through it. I just used Machina, Cam, and Garnet. Like, my three best characters, basically. And it worked out great. Odin has a bunch of mechanics I didn't want to deal with. So I figured I'd just rush him down. It worked out fine. There may come a day where I revisit the first Dare to Defy stage and maybe use less busted characters, but I don't know. I'm not committing to anything. We'll see. I am seeing a lot of people are bringing that Lightning, Selfie, and General Leo team, and it works, but my god, does it take forever. I'm looking at that shit and it's like 90 something turns is the average, maybe even 100 for some of them. And I'm not talking about turn count, I'm talking about time spent. That just seems like a nightmare. Like, if you screw one thing up, you could just die after having been at this fight for like 85 turns or something. No thank you. I'm not going to do all that. Kudos to the people who are going to take the time to do that. I'm not going to be one of them. Oh hey, Freya got FR enhancements. And this probably wasn't a wise decision, but I just maxed her to 30. But she's a favorite, so I don't give a shit. But this I don't like. Plus 5% that I don't like. This is actually my first time using Titus with the burst, because I just got it today. I had LD Titus since the beginning, but I just got burst Titus today and the FR. So my Titus is ready. Blue armor, the works, everything. You already saw it in the beginning. I don't need to repeat that. You already saw it. I showed you a picture. Why am I talking about this? What the hell kind of mechanic is that? They just blow bubbles and get rid of your brave? Like, that's not threatening at all. Not even a little bit. And I did not do what I normally like to do here, which would be go into the burst when the fourth time is at 7. We went in at 6 because Freya kind of messed up the turn order with falling to the ground and then having to take 2 turns to jump back up. But that's okay, I don't give a shit. I'm not going for burst flex here. I'm going for a 2-turn run with Freya, and it worked out great. And I wanted to try out Titus. So that's what we did. I don't even know if what I'm doing here is an optimal burst rotation for Titus. I kind of just wanted to go in with a free skill and then spam those slash combos. Don't know if that's the right move, but it worked out fine anyway. And my burst damage was exceptionally low for what it could have been, so do not take this overall burst damage as a reliable showcase for what Titus's damage generally is. Because if you build right, it is so much more than what I did here. Spoiler alert, it was only like 89 million. That's not much at all. compared to like what Machina's been doing and shit, the Titus can hit those same numbers. He really can. Just set up better than I did. Again, this is not a burst flex. This is just me getting the run done. I have also decided, and I'm going to decree, okay, I've been playing Titus for a good hour here. Burst Titus, everything. That's my Titus experience is about an hour. So with my Titus experience, I am going to decree that the only way to properly play Titus is to have Titus's C65 on the front page. And I understand all of you purists out there are going to be like, but no, the EX is supposed to go on the front page. That's not right. That is not the correct skill order. Hear me out. This way, you can spam skill 1 and the C65 as fast as possible and have Titus just jump around, do all these flips and quick hits and all this shit. He's just darting around the whole screen, not giving a shit. It's awesome. So that's what I like to do. I like to just spam the quick hits from the C65s as fast as possible without flipping pages, just so he can flip around and have fun and do his thing. It's his story. His story is C65 on the front page. I don't care what anybody says. That is his story. This music that is playing right now is intentional. It wasn't. I just thought of this right now. It's only here because a few reasons. One, I like it. Two, I didn't feel like downloading anything else. And three, it's an homage to Final Fantasy X. These are Bad Religion songs played 8-bit. And what better band to accompany a game like Final Fantasy X? Because let's be honest, Final Fantasy X is clearly a blatant mockery on things like organized religion and cult thinking in every sense. So I just thought this music was fitting. And victory is ours. Wonderful. I am curious as to who you guys ran, and I'm more curious as who you're going to run for the Dare to Defy version of this. But until next time, hope you guys enjoyed, and thank you for watching.